All right, so we have here a HP 13-AE 009TU. So this one, we had the battery replaced for them, and it works fine with the battery, but it doesn't charge the battery apparently. Okay, so they suspect maybe something wrong with the Type-C port. They've got a new charger as well, and or the original HP charger. So let's see where the issue is and why it's not charging the battery. Okay, so we're going to disassemble this one. There's a name. We'll just hide the screen for now until I remove the bottom panel. Okay, looks like nothing on one of the ribbons. Okay. Okay, here we go. So, top cover is open, and this is the inside. That's the battery we replaced. The old one was swollen, or I don't know, it wasn't working. Okay, so that's the battery voltage. Interesting. That's the chip I need for the earlier video I made for 13-AE. It's exactly the chip I need. Okay. Oh my god, this is actually the same motherboard, but a different casing. Wow, okay, it's gonna be a tough one, okay. You can watch the earlier video. There's one about the Type-C, okay. So we got a Type-C issue or not, so I need to figure out something first, okay. So, power on. Wakey wakey. Okay, it's coming on. Now that's working off the battery. Now I'll connect just a standard 5 volt type C. There is a negotiation. Oh, here we go. 0.7 amps. That's not right. Okay. How about here? Same thing. 2.5 and then 0.5. Okay. Okay, so I'll bring in the Type-C controller charger. So we can monitor what happens when we plug in the charger. Okay. Computer's currently on. The 20 volts. Okay. So it's not taking any current. 0. Oh, here we go, 1 amp. Okay. It says it's charging. The battery is full. And I'm trying the port here, that's also charging. So what's the issue? Okay. So what am I supposed to do with this? Okay. Okay. In off stage, battery's fully charged, so I'm not concerned that it's not taking any amp. Let's disconnect the battery. Okay. So the negotiation is good. Voltage negotiation. It should technically power on from there. Mate, nothing happens for not for any reason. You know, the job I was working on today, I want to check something here. Check the enable signal and microscope. Let's have a look at that. After the GAP chip. Okay, so which is there, that's the GAP. Yep, there we go. GAP, that one there. Okay, let's make it sharper. Okay, have a look at voltage mode. So this will be the 20 volts. Yeah, that's fine. And same here. Oh. It should be zero. How about here? So this on the other one is much higher. That's why this chip is getting hot on the other one. The issue is with this line. That's coming from there, here, there, 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 there from this guy. So what I'll do is I'll cut the power out of this. Okay, so here, there, there, most likely here. Now let's check if that goes to that other chip over here. Try that guy on the bottom. Okay, I'd like to know. Okay, let's go bring. No, this has become a different job. I want this one. So this leg here on this one is got a much higher voltage. Let's go back. Power, power, power. So we should hear that 20 volts coming in and going out non-stop. Yeah, so this one has a higher voltage. This voltage should not be coming. That voltage should not be there. Okay, cut the power. So we need to find out where is it coming from. So we know it's going there to here. There, from there to here. Okay, let me check resistance to ground there. That is increasing. 10 kiloohms. Here. Connected. They're not connected. Oh, they are. That's connected here. That should be connected here. Yeah. And this is? So these two are 10 kilo ohms on the bad board. Okay, now on the other one. Yeah, nothing happens for without a reason. This is like, it's meant to come today. This is great. So on the good board, here, 10, correct. 10, also correct. Oh, he's going there. So why, on the other one it's not, let me double check. Right, how about the other one? Okay. Which one of these, where is, okay. What's happening out here then? That's ground. That's 2.39 voltage drop, okay. And on this one, that's ground. Yep. And here. Same, but this is more stable. Look at the bottom bar. That's steady. Let me check the other one again. You can see it's jumping. Okay. Resistance. That's going to be ground here. On the bad board, 15.28 kilo ohms. That's in the mega ohms range, okay. And on here, that's good here. 26. I wonder where he's going. Here on the bad board, it's much lower. Okay, this is a problem. We need to find where he's going. Let me see if that's going anywhere near. This chip. None of these. How about these MOSFETs? Can't seem to find anything there. How about on this guy? Where are you going, mate? Let me check on the other side of the board, on the other one. Okay, so what are we going to do now? Plug in the charger on this one and check the voltage of those legs. Of that guy on the bottom. Okay, we're in voltage mode, plug in the charger. This is a good board. Here, 3.3, which is, that's not the same. Oh, that's here, 3.3. That should be 3.3. Okay, I think I miscalculated. Let me double check in continuity again. So, from there to here. From there to there. From there. Maybe that's ground. No? It's 10 kiloohms resistor. From there to there. 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 Okay, let me see if that's the case. One more time, voltage mode. Voltage. This is a good board. Zero. 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 Zero, 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 3.3, and that's ground. Yeah, on the faulty board. It could be that this one is turning on, and the other one is not turned on. Yeah? This is now going through its mental stages. Okay. So here needs to be 0, 3.3, I can't remember. Yeah, that one needs to be 3.3. Which is same as the voltage here, which doesn't really reach 3.3. Cuts off. Yeah, that explains. Okay, something's not right. I need to know Let me see if I can turn on the client one while on. Check the voltage. Currently on, and spin. I don't know, it's on. We have 5 volts here. 3.3. Yep. And on this diode here, 3.36. Here will be high voltage. Oh no, it's not. Interesting. It's 19. That's ground. Why the hell is 19 volts going there? That's why this diode is actually protecting, not allowing more current to go through, which is good. And it's getting so. We replaced that chip on the other one, but the leg here is 19 volts on the other one. That was enable. Why is enable giving? Well, that's enable. Very tricky situation. Alright, I'm gonna see if I can find a schematic. Okay, let's do a board search. DA 0 x33 nothing. It looks like it is not available. Okay. It's one of those situations. Can't find anything on the Discord forum either. We'll use a technique someone recommended earlier to find, potentially find, where it may be. My mind is a little bit of a mess at the moment. Okay. Okay. We'll use this guy. Okay. We need to find. We need to sort this mess out later. Okay. So I want to know where that 19 volts is coming from to that chip there. Okay. Bring a wire. So we'll make this like a brush. The first time trying this technique. And okay, let me see where I made a mistake. So we're going to point this there. And we need to find where his other side is going. Okay. Okay, so that's our black probe. In continuity. Okay. All right. So this is basically our probe. I want to know where that guy's going. If we know in this area, that's fine. Let's have a look at here. Kookaburra is going mental behind me. Nice. Cheering me on. Go, go, go. You can hear him. He's celebrating the success of. See you later. Awesome, Indian miners. Where? Do you know there? No problem. That's a replacement chip gap. I mean, we replaced that chip. Here it is. I doubt it will be around the CPU area. So what if we remove that chip on here, which is K72, and let's see what happens to power supply. Now it's not ideal to turn this unit on without that guy being in there. So let's see what fire will start. Plug in the power. We have 20 volts. Still no power drawing. And shutting down. Okay. So problem is still present. Explanation. All begins with that diary. After gap, the diode. And when we plug it in now, and it will stay on 20 volts, and there will be no cutting out of the power. Which is correct. As you can see, it's still powered on. Yeah, 20 volts. But it's not pulling any power. Oh, wait. Wow. Something's hot. Or it's just the heat I applied. Interesting. Around here was getting warm. Could be wrong. Double check. So we got 20 volts current, 20 volts, but no current. Oh, here we go. Power did cut out. That's 5 volts now. Here we go. Now it's doing something strange. Now it's resetting. Okay, now we won't do any voltage negotiation. It's stuck at 5 volts. Let me try another port. And now it's got 20 volts. And the board is cold, nothing's happening. Okay. So we can put that chip back here. But it's not gonna do anything because from up there, the voltage is not coming down. At least we can check its legs off that gap chip to see what's happening. Okay, so let's plug in the power and just check the voltage. So okay. Okay, so we're in DC mode. Ground, give me a ground. Okay. Yeah, we're in diode mode. Voltage. So there will be no voltage here. Holy shit, it still has 19 volts. So where is it getting its voltage from? From that leg. So this still has 19 volts, yeah? Yeah. Here? Why does this guy have 19 volts? Shouldn't have 19 volts. Let me check the schematics for that file again, for that gap chip. Enable signal. Voltage in, enable to ground voltage, enable to wind voltage. A rating up to 27 volts. Okay. I understand why they put a diode there to stop 19 volts all of a sudden coming out from that port. Okay, I've disconnected power. Diode mode. Where are you getting your power from? Is it really coming from there? What if I remove this chip again? Will it have 19 volts here? Let me check that. That would be a good way to tell. Because I can't tell at the moment where he's getting his 19 volts from. Okay, let the board cool down a little bit. Now we'll look in voltage mode. Okay, connect the charger. Yeah. Something is giving enable signal. Enable signal. Enable. 20 volts. Ridiculous. Here we won't have anything because it's not the chip's fault, but wherever that guy is going is where our problem is. Why is the enable 20 volts? Okay, so far. Now, one more thing I want to verify is if I remove this guy here. Okay. Okay, whatever. See if you got still 20 volts. Let me know where it's coming from. Yeah, nah. It's coming from somewhere else. It's not generated by those chips. But where is it coming from? No power at the moment. Where is it coming from? How can we know where it's coming from? It has to be coming from this side of the board because it is a high voltage. It won't be coming from the other side. Okay. Let's think of it that way. It has to be coming from the high power source. Now let's check these guys. Could be from a capacitor, output from a MOSFET. Make sure. So none of these MOSFETs are responsible for it. Okay, no. Just trying to think of ideas. This is ridiculous. Maybe it's from a VGA chip. If it was a VGA chip, we will know. Legs will be, you'll show up on the thermal cam. Okay, how about around the battery? How about this guy? Didn't pay attention to him. Let me go around to him. Maybe first it has to touch one of these guys. Absolutely nothing. Bizarre. Was there something there? It's been removed. Not sure. That cap has been moved. Okay. Yeah, this is the same. Why am I checking here? No idea. Just for sanity's mind. Okay. This is the only link I can think of. What if I remove that link? A 10k ohms resistor. Speaking of tiny, that's tiny. Stay. Okay. All right, let's check for voltage. Plug in the charger. No 20 volts. Gotcha. Unless I'm doing something wrong. Let me double check. So there should be 20 volts here. Correct. And how about here? Okay. Shit, I put my hand on the coil. Okay, that's fine. Now that resistor should be 10k ohms. Yeah, there we go. 10k ohms. Yes, he did a runner. Do you see it? I got him. Okay. Alright, I'll come back to the video.